But do they have the wrong suspect?
I didn't do anything.
Let's see the video.
Today on Swift Justice with Nancy Grace. The cases are real. The decisions are binding. And justice will be swift. Court starts now on Swift Justice with Nancy Grace.
Nancy Grace here. We just got a report that Heath's truck has been stolen. So we gonna figure this shit out.
Solve this mystery, baby. Let's go, man. This ain't a joke, baby. Let's go.
Okay, so as you guys know, this past weekend, we were all at Playlist, Heath and I and everybody else. I went out of town the 26th to go back home to Florida to see my family, and Heath left last Wednesday to come to Florida so we can all drive up Friday. So that's why I wasn't able to upload Monday. This weekend's been really hectic. I lost my voice. Playlist, I had a lot to do, and a lot of you guys were out there, so I didn't want to like film too much. I just wanted to meet you guys. I flew back in last night, Monday night. I didn't look in the garage. I went straight to my room, and I like went to bed because I was exhausted. I flew in late. And this morning, I go to my Jeep so I can drive to Scott and Todd, and Heath's truck is gone. As soon as I saw that, I didn't immediately think that Heath's truck was stolen. I thought, oh, Heath must have let somebody like borrow the truck, let Matt borrow the truck, or you know, Matt had to like move furniture. He just got a new place.
Yeah, and then you called me and you were like, yeah. Matt, do you have Heath's truck? And I'm just like,
exactly.
No.
I called Heath, he didn't answer. I texted him and told him to call me ASAP. So like, I was driving to Scott and Todd's. I just got there, and Heath calls me, and I was like, hey, buddy, just wondering, you know your truck's gone, right? And he goes, what do you mean my truck's gone? I'm like, dude, your truck's not there. Did you know that somebody was gonna borrow it while you're gone? He's like, dude, stop fucking with me. Is my truck gone? I'm like, dude, yes, your truck's not supposed to be gone. Then somebody has it. And then he starts freaking out, and immediately I'm like, okay, well, before we freak out, obviously David pranks people all the time. We have a couple other people that like to prank people. So immediately I'm like, all right, Heath, let me call David and see if he has it. Hang up. I call David. David's just like, no, dude, I don't have his truck. He would have immediately told me because I told him we were going to call a cop. I hung up. I call Heath again. I'm like, your truck is gone. My Jeep wasn't broken into. I get to Scott and Todd's house. I call the police and like, I tell them everything. And they tell me that I can't really call about a missing truck. Heath has to call, but Heath is in Florida and he's not home. So when he calls 911, it's going to direct his call to a police station in Florida. So I called Dan. I'm like, let me tell you all the information. So I tell him as much information as I could, and they didn't seem really like, you know, they were just like, okay, like lost, like stolen car. They didn't really like care. So he calls our landlord. She said there's security cameras in our garage, but she was like at a seminar, so she couldn't like look at the footage at the moment. So we're just like sitting there. I'm like, how did Heath's truck, like only Heath's truck from this garage? It's, by the way, it's locked. Like you need a code to get in. We're so confused. I decided to go check my Jeep to see if his spare key is gone. I check my Jeep and it's fucking gone. Oh. Somebody broke into our garage. Went into my Jeep. I don't know if they broke in, if it was unlocked. I lock my Jeep every time I leave. I can't say my Jeep was locked. I told Heath, I'm like, Heath, dude, your spare key is gone from my Jeep. And he's like, dude, did you lock your Jeep? I'm like, dude, I can't tell you if I locked my Jeep or not, but I'm telling you right now, I never leave my Jeep unlocked. Like, I keep it locked at all times. It's my fucking baby. It just doesn't make sense, like, how somebody come into our garage, go to my Jeep, find his key, and then take Heath's truck. Like, it's, we feel like somebody knew where we lived and somebody knew that we were out of town, because out of all these days they decided to do this. They waited till we're at Playlist in Florida. Right now we already called the cops, like Heath already filed the police report, but we're trying to figure out exactly what happened. But my landlord was able to send me screenshots of the footage of the people in the garage. The first picture that got sent to me was like a little girl. I was like, a little girl stole Heath's truck? But no, I looked at all the pictures. Hold on. It's a big guy on a bike. He's wearing all black. His friend is a little girl.
Oh, is she wearing Ugg boots?
Just judging the people that stole Heath's truck right now.
I think I know this motherfucker.
Are you serious?
This kid, you know how, I don't know.
Hold on, does he look like that kid?
Look at that jawline. That kid that I know has that particular jawline who comes around by Heath's apartment all the time. I already checked his Instagram because I got suspicious.
Dude, Nancy Grace up in this bitch!
Baby, that's what I do. Matt, I solved
the mystery. Did he just solve this?
The thing is, if we put this in there though, we can't expose that kid though.
Of course we can. He stole Heath's truck. He fucking committed a crime.
If that is him, here, I'll show you on my Instagram. The thing that is making me have doubts is the bicycle. Dude, I really do think someone around your apartment has been dealing drugs. I've been seeing really sketchy people coming by late at night, hanging out. And one of them in particular, I know their faces. Every time I walk up and I see them.
They're like
best friends. One of the guy always has a big old hat and the other guy looks just like that.
Oh, hold on. What time is that?
At 4 a.m.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so my landlord told me that when I got in last night, because she was checking the footage, the truck was still there. So this happened while I was sleeping. So this happened within the past 12 hours. So they probably thought we were still out of town
at
that moment.
Check Craigslist.
Hold on, is that a good...
Yes, that's what I was
saying. Oh, shit!
I got my laptop right here. Step number one, we are gonna check Craigslist.
There you go. It's a red Ford Lightning.
Oh, there it is. I mean, if we type in Ford Lightning, most recent one that comes up...
Is...
No, that's a month ago.
Damn it. Like, they've already wrecked it.
Well, what other sites would you be able to post?
OfferUp.com.
If they stole this car, would they just post it?
No, but if they were dumb enough, they would. But you know what? They're dumb enough to rob a car with security camera footage.
No, baby. They're dumb to rob off here. We fun to expose them because we got footage. It shouldn't be not allowed for us to put these people on the internet. They stole his fucking truck.
We're taking the matter into our own hands. Exactly. We have every right to do this. Pete's car got stolen. They knew we were out of town. They did it at 4 a.m. this
exactly.
morning.
Exactly.
The week was already started. They would have stole it over the weekend.
They're app playlists. We gotta get over there. Now they'll be gone another day.
Yeah, right. They had no.
Dude, this is the last time we can steal it.
You need a code? And 4 in the morning? Dude, there's no way that they were waiting on somebody to open the gate. Like, you're not gonna sit at our apartment at 4 in the morning and wait for someone to leave for it to open. Like, somebody let you in or you knew the code to get in.
What's interesting though, since they have a bike, that means they live in the neighborhood. Whoever stole it lives probably 2 blocks away.
Gee, I wonder which one of the 500 people who wait out your door it could have been.
No, that's the thing though, like,
hey, completely unsafe.
At 4 a.m., we need to go around the neighborhood and look for people on bikes.
Ooh, let's make it a whole.
Let's make it a car now.
Get night vision goggles and we're just fucking driving around every night just looking. Even if we find his truck, we just want to catch him.
Do you remember that one day, those guys who I think may have stolen? Remember they were outside looking at that really nice car they had, and they had one of those mirror things and they were going around it.
I remember us seeing that. We questioned it, but we didn't know if it was like a thing.
They had a white Mercedes when they did that, and the next time I saw them, they were in a different car.
Baby! Matt is figuring it out.
Where's your night goggles?
What? That's David in the military. David, can you please stop making puns? We need to catch the terrorists.
Look at this guy. That's who fucking stole your
thing. Oh my god, hold on. Let me look at the footage again. The guy on the bike looks bigger than him.
Those are thief gloves. He is robbing shit.
Someone that would do this doesn't have like a Twitter account. Yeah, he doesn't have doesn't post a lot on Instagram.
Yeah, true. I don't know. He runs with a rough crew. I think they're dealing cocaine, because who's buying weed in Los Angeles when it's legal out here?
That's true.
And people who do cocaine are up at 4 in the morning.
There's a video of him performing on stage, and his body looks just like the body in the screenshot.
Oh shit. Look. Look how he changes hats. That's the hat.
Oh my god, Matt. I think it is a hat. Hold on. I think that's him.
I know.
It's him.
So you think it's a girl?
Jason.
No, look at the jawline. It has a very distinct.
Jason, come here. Go to the picture of him. This is the photo that they have of him.
He's wearing gloves.
Wow.
Look at that hat.
Yeah,
you can barely see it, but it's big
and
logo. It's
definitely flat brimmed.
And then this is his friend who, look, and show the other kid who has a very distinct jawline.
I thought it was a girl. Hold on, right here. This looks like he has black hair. I thought it was a girl. Looks like a girl.
Look at him. He looks like a woman.
Ooh.
Okay, go to his other pictures.
It's so hard to be a criminal nowadays with the internet.
I accidentally.
He was looking through the kid's Instagram that he thinks that took the. And he fucking liked one of his pictures.
I'm sorry.
Idiot.
He posted 3 hours ago and I was trying to see, like.
Guess what? He follows him, so he probably got notified that Matt King, Heath's friend, just liked the picture. So right now they know that.
Stop! If I knew he stole it, why would I like his photo? You know?
He's gonna be he's looking through my page.
No. I was trying to zoom in on the tattoo. That is gonna help the police.
You're ruining the investigation.
I know, god damn it.
A hire a team of police come into the building. Matt, you've just interfered and tampered with evidence that-
I'm in court, like, months later going, I liked the Instagram photo.
Can we get something to eat? I'm hungry.
Maybe all this investigation is making me hungry.
Yeah. We were at Panera Bread and the cashier was like, all right, here's your change. I'm like, thank you. Where were you at 4 a.m. last night, huh?
All right, so right now we're on our way to our landlord's house because she has the full footage of them moving and everything. We only have pictures, but Matt kind of need to see them moving.
Identify really their body types, maybe gender. Exactly. Really just kind of like solidify if they are who we suspect they are at the moment. If it is not the people we think it is, I'm still going to be taking notes. Down to the shoes, down to the hat.
One of the guys that I saw, he'll put money down that it is him. He looks just like him. Like, there was a video of him performing on stage and he had the same body type.
Anyway, I can't believe though his last Instagram is wearing gloves. And there's no motorcycle. If you have gloves like that, you have a motorcycle. There's not one motorcycle.
Exactly. Oh my god, everything just fits perfectly except for that bike.
The bicycle is the missing piece, right?
Why are they riding around in a bike?
Because every time I've seen them, it's been in a nice car. And
they're purposely trying to go into our apartment to steal something in our apartment, why do they need a bike? Usually, if you're gonna have a bike, you're going to different apartment complexes.
Yeah.
But these kids that are affiliated with this apartment, why do you need a bike?
bike.
We gon' figure this shit out.
Solve this mystery.
Shit.
Dude, all I want is a Range Rover.
Baby, all I want is justice. I wish Heath was with us right now because this is his truck, you know? He's back in Florida right now just having to deal with his like truck being missing. And we don't want to tell Heath about this just yet because we don't know if it's them or not. We don't want to get Heath's hopes up right now. We want to make sure it's them. Then we're going to tell Heath and try to go from there. Yes. All right. But we also know that they were there between 4:01 and 4:08 a.m. We have learned that through the footage, but we have not seen it yet.
But we know that there were two suspects. Also, the bike. Was the bike theirs or was it Heath's?
Mm-hmm. All right. So what we know.
David is not a suspect.
There you go. What we also know is that it may be a fan.
True.
We know for a fact that one of the suspects are either a male or a female.
Okay, good.
There we go. We're doing great.
So right now, we're in the management office looking at the security.
You're doing, and then he's looking at, he's like, yeah, I'm gonna get out of here now. He works here, he works with this company, and he just left. And when he was leaving, he left the door open, just waiting there, not saying it. There's no way this
he was outside when he walked up. Remember that?
Oh my god, he was. He's like, yeah, IT guys, I'm just fixing up your video.
So crazy, he works.
Is this happening?
Matt and I have now two different people that we think it is because we are able to fully see these two people. Like, we're able to see the second person that we didn't know if it was a boy or a girl. We saw her more as she was walking to the apartment complex, and she was had like a full head of hair. Right now, we believe that she sent us an email a long time ago because of something that she, I don't want to talk about it, but it was like something really weird that happened.
Right now, I'm hunting down her old email she sent and trying to find her photo. She deleted her Twitter and turned her Instagram on private.
This is her.
That could be her.
Look at that, the length of the
hair. No, that dude, that could be her. That's.
And she deleted her Twitter. And guess what her old bio said?
What?
Dancing with the devil.
Jesus.
We need to get to the security camera footage.
Now. At the scene of the crime.
Where's your teeth?
That's got it on.
I came out and I was like, oh my god.
My teeth is gone too. Shit.
Why is that door open? Anything else room?
What? That's not our room. Our room's on there.
This is like a horror movie.
I know.
Hello?
This is our room. This is our storage room.
No, they didn't fuck with anybody else's door, so they came in here and they went straight for our door. How did they know that this was our storage? Okay, so right here. No, they don't have our keys though.
They picked it?
Alright, so we have 10 rooms in here, storage rooms, and no other room was like tampered with except for our door. And our door has like all these marks on it.
It's gonna be.
They took his bike! Are you fucking kidding me? Why did they take his bike?
But they didn't take the Celsius.
This
person has been to your apartment before.
There's a room in our complex where there's basically, they hold the footage in there.
The camera.
I don't know.
It's incredible how discreet they are. They thought, look, I can't even see the cameras.
I think those are cameras right there.
Wow. Motion sensors at least.
I don't know what any of this shit is.
The way she described it, she goes this. I mean, it's up. Wait, that's water and power. It's this. That's not it.
I can't believe you work for the fucking government.
I'm pretty sure it's this thing.
There's something about this
that looks pretty.
Is that it? Dead. Oh my god, yes! It worked!
Look, okay. We got every
Oh my god, Matt!
I did it!
All right. Are you able to look
at like, we can watch it live anytime.
Are you kidding me? Okay.
So look, let's go to playback.
Okay.
He's on a bike.
Maybe
they took it before. No.
Where does he put the bike?
Who is that? That's the girl.
You get close on that. She was on the bike.
She has long wavy hair.
During this time, she somehow gets into the garage.
They're all geared up.
Look at that. He takes her backpack and I think she goes in to open up the garage. He waits down by the garage for it to open.
But how does she get?
Okay, so this is another camera angle of them in the garage.
So they went to each car.
Yeah. I bet they opened up your car, saw the pair of keys, realized it didn't go to that pair of keys, and then Heath's car probably beeped, and then they went in Heath's car and took it. Because they had to have seen that. They go, oh, this is for the car next to it.
So my Jeep was unlocked.
But then he goes in and comes out with a bike.
Exactly.
God, I wish I could go back in time and just catch these
wheels. I know. Okay, so she finds a key, realizes that it's for that truck.
She's probably calling for him going, I found a car.
She didn't even attempt it, though. He's in there for a while. He's in that storage room.
Going lock after lock.
Lock after lock.
She went over there. No, that's just him coming out with the bike.
Okay. There she is. Okay. What blows my mind is that they take their time. They don't like
rush. It's 4 a.m. because no one's waking up.
And there they go. All right, so he comes out of the side door. But Heath's bike was gone already. So, dude, they must have taken his bike
earlier.
And then she opens the garage door. Why is it going so slow?
Wait.
There it is. Now that's the culprit. There she go with his big red. We gonna find you, bitch.
All right, guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to like this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more stuff from me and all my friends. Shout out the week goes to Ava. Thank you so much for keeping up with all my stuff and watching all my videos. I really appreciate it. All right, guys, Heath lost something very important in the past 2 days. And if we could do everything we can to try to just be on the lookout for big red. It's a Ford Lightning F-150, sporty red.
With black rims.
And yeah.
She's out there alone.
She's out there all alone.
Dark
or in pieces.
Stop.
This is what we know. It all went down between 4:01 and 4:08 a.m.